What's keeping you still playing Marvel Contest of Champions, the swipe tap Marvel game available on mobile? Yes. Hello, everybody. Welcome to a topic-based video. Why not do proper videos, Rich? Well, they're coming soon. I'm just taking a bit of a little break. And I'll be back in full force on Monday covering a lot of, like, more proper things and proper guides and less topic-based videos is what that is. So, yeah, it's nice to take a bit of time. That's the thing that goes well into the topic today. With all due respect, what keeps you going with the game? A lot of things keep me playing the game. I'll just go over my personal perspective is there's always things that, you know, you put targets. And something that I've talked about a long time. Targets. If you put targets in game, it's something that you're looking to achieve. One of those things is having small or kind of like short, medium and long targets depending on where you're at in the game. My short-term target is to become Valiant by the 31st of January, which I'm doing at the moment, going through one of those laborious tasks in my fifth run of Necropolis, which is just, I'm so bored. I am so bored and I cannot wait for this to be over, which I've got to go in one more time before the 31st of January, right? My medium target is to revamp and redo my champions, rank up certain ones, attach relics, sort out my relics, change my relics around, and thirdly, change my masteries. And I think then my long-term one is to improve my banquet Battlegrounds deck and add in a new loadout switch for that. So that's my plan, is to kind of like short, medium, long based on certain things. Being free to play means that you have to be very careful about your rank ups, but also there's a lot of champions I do want to rank up. Add more champions by the medium of 6-star shard acquisition and going through the featured. But of course I need to get more 6-star shards, and one of the best ways to kind of get them for the 6-star featured is indeed Battlegrounds Storewood. Now I have nothing because I haven't been able to do Battlegrounds this season round, which has been very disappointing, but that's just because I need to become Valiant, because again, it all helps out the process. Get those dailies. Those daily crystals are fantastic to build a free to play roster around. But in any case, that is what keeps me going. Targets. Achieving short, medium and long targets that I set myself. And also try and live around those. But it was interesting because I wanted to kind of go through what other players like about the game. Because obviously games need to be challenging. Of course I have the affinity to Marvel characters. That is it. That was kind of the main reason. I like Marvel characters. I collect Marvel comic books. I even collect fancy things. Like, I'm not, by the way, this is not sponsored or anything, but they were on offer. It's the new Funko pins. Like, I don't know why. I saw these two here and I just absolutely love them. You know, Storm, like, love the design. Thought that's perfect. And grab that. And also a Colossus one. So, yeah, that's... Anyway, yeah, so there's, by the way, I'm not in condoning those or kind of saying other types of collectibles are available. I saw them, they were on offer, they were half price. So I was like, I'm going to grab them. But yeah, Marvel characters. Everyone loves Marvel characters. And also playing a Marvel mobile game on the move can be great. So what is keeping players still playing this game? So Dr. Doom says, back in 2019, I randomly came across MCOC in the Play Store and also the likeness towards Marvel heroes. I saw some clips on YouTube as well. In the early days, I didn't know what I was getting into and how it really works, but as the game and I progressed over the time, I got used to it, got addicted, and also using the champions who I used to see on TV or movie. Now I'm playing as them in a mobile game. Now looking back at the time, it sure was a nostalgic trip starting back then and still going. At times, I thought of quitting as well, but my likeness of somewhat of this game became my escape from world situations for some time, in a good way. That's a story, though. I would love to hear from you, like how, what, what's your story, and what is that still keeps you going good in the game after all these years. So yeah, just the fact I enjoy it, like that. That's to the point. Black Cat's victory animation. That seems just too kinky for my liking. The joy of mindless repetition in pursuit of a virtual doodad that helped me continue my mindless repetition. Colin's got a lot of problems, and that I don't know if we're going to get the right answers here, but I think this looks like a right kind of like answer with this stuff. So in 2018, they might be happy with their own skin, by the way. So in 2018, my class, we used to talk a lot about the games we played. My friend one day told me about this game. I just forgot about it. In second Saturday of Jan 2019, I was too bored to remember about this game. I downloaded it. In the first tutorial screen, I'm able to see Venom, my favorite Marvel character. And I went in like hell yeah. Within 2 months, I was able to get better with than my friend, which was my initial motive to play the game. You know, nothing says friendship like rivalry. Then by 2020 Feb, after a year, I opened a 6-star crystal, became Cavalier, and eventually lost interest in the game. After a month break in April, lockdown forced me to play again. I got into Friendly Alliance and made a hell of a lot of friends in line, and it went well. Then around August, I had to fight in line with another player. I am a stupid kid back then who would take it personally. But anyway, to avoid all the drama, I just uninstalled Line and played the game for some time until 2020. By the way, I quit Line about five, I think it's been 5 and 7 years ago. So if anybody thinks that they've contacted me or I've contacted them, it's not me. I don't use Line. December, when 7.1 was launched, I was still Cavalier at the time. Then, after a 2-year long break, I came back in MCOC in 2023. And it's all fun since then. Good. Also, I love you guys in the forum. You're friendly and supportive. That doesn't sound like the forums, but I'm glad that's the case. This player loves the graphics, the constant drip of new content, and how it's equal parts fighting and puzzle game. I don't think it's really a puzzle game. There's a lot of games that are very much puzzle game. I'd say... Well, unless they're referring to like understanding abilities versus nodes and behaviors and patterns of play and relics and other elements of strategy. It's more strategy. It's turning more fighting and strategy. It's like chess, really. It's kind of like fighting chess. Group. That still keeps me playing again. Okay. To get a champion from arenas and then stare at the wall and reflect over my life. A lot of people are having like midlife crisis is... That seems to be the case. Been asking myself a lot this month. Not really sure these days. I'm closer to walking away than ever. I thought we had some positivity here. I really don't like the direction of the game's taken heading into 2024 after a stellar second half of 2023. Really? Road to the Crypt was a good idea. Necropolis and accessing Valiant and the hypocrisy of Cyber Weekend and Banquet Event. That's debatable, but I understand it comes from a good place. But there's been a lot of quality of life improvements that I've liked what they've done. I love Marvel. I love to learn more about Marvel characters that I don't know about. So it's about what keeps me going and learning these new faces I wouldn't have known. Love that. That's wholesome. That's what we want to hear. At the moment, just 8.4. I did Necropolis completion, and now I'm just waiting on 8.4 so I can get Valiant free to play. Past that, I'm not really sure. For me as well, there's something like Marvel Contest of Champions is kind of like a bridging gap between playing World of Tanks, which I'm kind of like a veteran player of, and what would be GTA 6. That's going to be the thing, GTA 6. I'm not going to say like I'm going to quit like playing MCOC or quit covering it. I'm just going to have to be very careful because I do want to play GTA 6. Like, I've wanted to play that since, finished with GTA 5. But we'll have to see. You know, the future is yet unknown. It hasn't been written. We'll have to write it together, shall we? The main reason is that I'm a huge fan of Marvel, and this is really the only fighting game like this on mobile since it was released. And I really do love the game, but I have been finding myself more frustrated because of the AI. I think we're all in the same boat with that one. Then really enjoy it once I did. The final thing that keeps me playing is I have invested a lot of time and money in the game. So, you know, I think that's a lot of, because people invest, like, because you're not saying suck it in, but once you've invested a lot of time, you want it to kind of like succeed. It's like the same thing with why people support their football teams, or if you're American, soccer. If you invest a lot of time, and it's saying your sporting team, if you invest a lot of time into your sporting team, they're not always going to win. They're not always going to lose. They may get a draw depending on the type of sport. And you will have highs and lows, ups and downs, but you'll still find yourself supporting. You won't go away from it, especially if it's your hometown team. You'll be supporting for years on years, even if things don't go well or go bad. You're like, well, I'm always here. I'm here to the bitter end. That's always it. To see Caban bring back pre-11.0 Scarlet Witch. No, not, that's never going to happen. 10 years, yeah. My alliance. So that's a lot of things like alliance, camaraderie, one of the key elements that people like. The sheer amount of money I've invested. People are honest. They're very honest with this. Sometimes it's thinking about the money I've spent. Oh, God, it's money, isn't it? I like this game since it doesn't have a constant advertisement. I tried playing other mobile games. That's true. I keep getting bombarded with ads. Also, if it was Punisher, Ghost, Cosmic Ghost Rider, and others, cool Marvel characters, nice. My alliance mates have become like family over the years. Even though many of us have moved on to other alliances, I've invested quite a bit of money into it. Money in it. I've dramatically reduced the amount that I play, though, because of the frustrations with the game itself. Yeah, controversially for some, arena, not grinding for champs, just the ability to fight after fight with little other input. I'm like that because I need units. Like, it's a free-to-play thing, isn't it? I love to play without actually thinking too hard and mostly play MCC to unwind and clear my head. I genuinely think the mindlessness of arena is good for my mental health. I actually agree with that. I'll watch a movie and play it at the same time. And you might be thinking, that's weird, isn't it? No, you pocket the units that you get and you're able to invest into stuff like Necropolis. Most of my Necropolis units of the 18,000 I set aside, like, was done by just mindlessly doing arena whilst watching movies. And is that such a crime and so bad? No, actually did what it needed to do. Anyway, keeping up to date in front of and being a front runner, like a challenge. Lack of real life substance outside the game. All right. Boredom mostly. Beast Dad never kind of minces his words. It's always to the point. Yeah. In any case, that is it. I'll put a question to you all in the comment section. What is the thing that's keeping you going in the game? Is it your alliance mates? Is it some of the new content? It's how you're tackling stuff. Is it the fact that you're in too deep because you've spent all this money? You spent all this time. What is your... Is it community camaraderie? What is it? What is it? Put it in the comment section. And yeah, check out some other content located on screen. And we'll be back to like more hard-hitting content next week when I'm back from my travels and things. Cheers, everybody. Have a great day. Bye-bye.